space, the final frontier. But what if it weren't? What if we were to go beyond space and into time? The mistakes of the past erased, the future reborn, the mortal and immortal made to decide their destiny together. Time is no longer an arrow, but an infinite expanse of possibilities. Explore this strange new world. Boldly go where not even a cue has gone before.
Hi there, watch lovers and enthusiasts in Canada and abroad. I'm just working on my Gruen watch that used to belong to my dad. And we're jumping in already partway through the disassembly. So sorry that you missed some of the parts of taking it apart. We have the nice dial here that I've already taken off, and it's in pretty good shape overall. And we'll just put that aside as we continue to take apart this watch, clean it, and put it back together, and hopefully that will get it back running after all these years. It was running at one point, but it then stopped, and my hopes is that it's just needed a good cleaning. The actual case, we've cleaned up as best I could with what it was around here, but it's still a little rough, but it's got some, obviously, age to it. And also, this won't be able to see, but it definitely looks like, if you can see that there, there's some markings. So the watch has had some service over the years. And hopefully this service will have it continue for a while longer. Now, one thing I noted when I started to take the automatic movement apart, when I flipped it over the plate here, so you see, one of those wheels down there has been rubbing against it over some time to create that mark. So I'm not sure why, but hopefully we'll get it all straightened out. All right. Now that we got the automatic winding off, we're going to try and back off the power on this here. We'll just back off the click and release the power from the spring. There we go. And it's got a lot of power already in it. Oh, I hear it spin there. So that seems to have released it. Okay, with power off, at least we're not going to have anything jumping out at us, hopefully. One thing to note when you're working on the winding area is this little spring, even if you're not even trying to take it off, will like to launch itself. And I was lucky enough to find it on the floor. Thank goodness we had hardwood flooring, or I might have never found it, but it is tiny and it flew. Just like they warned us, it will sometimes. But this is a challenge, and as you're probably looking at the progression of this video, I'm not an expert, just somebody that's getting interested in the hobby, and hopefully this video will help someone else that might have the same watch or same type of movement. It may need some information as to where things go back. I'm going to show a little video montage of the photographs of how it was taken apart, just so somebody will have reference to that as well. And also, as we're working on this, our better halves may be staring over our shoulders like they are right now, and they're probably wondering what the heck we are doing. But anyways, as Mr. Spock tried to tell somebody once,
I'm endeavoring, ma'am, to construct a mnemonic memory circuit using stone knives and bearskins.
And there's my stone knives and bearskins. All right. However, we're not using stone knives exactly, but it feels like it sometimes. And we're not trying to make a mnemonic memory circuit. We're trying to get this Gruen watch back together. And just so for reference, I have been carefully putting everything back into this holder, just so it kind of have an order of the way it came out and where it needs to go in the photos and the video we used as reference to get this back together. And let's make sure we do, because this is a anniversary watch from my father, who worked at De Lavelle in Peterborough. And some of you are probably saying, what the heck is a De Lavelle? Well, to answer the question about Alfa Laval, or De Lavelle, which became Alfa Laval later, a Swedish company that makes farming milk and cream separators and equipment. And this is an actual picture of the factory in Peterborough where my father worked. He's somewhere in this picture with the other 100 or so employees back in the 1941. And that's why he got the watch, for staying there for 25 years in the materials shipping and receiving department. So let's go continue on with our journey here and see if we can get this watch to be a runner. Let's get this tricky little spring back into place. If I don't get this on right away, which I probably not, we're going to pause this and then show you with it back on, because I'm not going to go searching for this thing again. So, as we've probably all seen on other videos that you've watched before this one, using a little bit of pegwood, hold her down as you're trying to get the spring into place so it doesn't fly away on you, or even use some Rodico to hold her down. Okay, yep, that's going to need some off-camera adjustments. All right, let's get some of these parts back on. All right, let's get this wheel back on. And from looking at my pictures, which I have right beside me, my cheat sheet, that one goes there. And looks like their next one. It's gonna fit in here. Like that. Alrighty, let's move on to the next one. Okay, now we're going to get this cover plate on over these two gears. It fits on like this. There's a little notch there. Can line it up with the hole. And then we get the screw, which is ever so tiny. And we try and get that screw into the hole. For you that might have been paying attention to that last scene there, you might have noticed that I was squeezing that screw a little too tightly with the tweezers, and it went into a black hole. So this screw is not the original screw. I've borrowed it from a quartz movement, one that I'm probably not going to ever use. It sort of fits. Let's hope it's going to work. So a little note for future jobs, don't squeeze the parts too tightly or they might just pop out of your tweezers. All right, let's get the rest of these parts on and hopefully we don't lose any more. Next, I'm going to put the center wheel in, at least that's what I'm going to call it. You can leave your comments if I'm using the wrong name, but it's going to go in the center. And the plate that goes over top of it with the screws, which they better not fly off this time. Put this plate over and get it secured. This plate, when I was taking it off, was really hard to get out. There's two pins on it that fit into the holes there. And it looks like they're press fitted down into there. So getting it off was really, really challenging. It's almost like it was stuck on there. There, now it's going in. Felt it go down. Okay, and we'll get the screw in there. A bit of magnetism on that screwdriver now. Not good. next wheel goes in over here into that little pivot hole. Like so. Okay. Next wheel. All right. And so we'll get the drum in there. If anybody's wondering why I'm doing it in this order, this is the order that I took it apart. So it might not necessarily be the correct way. Put it back together or even take it apart, but we're going the reverse order of how I tore this down, so to speak. All right, let's get that in and get the plate over it. All right, let's put the plate on over the main string barrel and then secure it down with the screws that I took out. All right, let's get the screws in to secure that like that there. And one will go there. Now let's get that in. Okay, we're going to continue with the train of wheels. Looking at my reference pictures, these two wheels are a little different. This one here will go in here, and this one is going to go in the center there. So if you can see that in the picture, it's got some perforations around the center of the pivot area. So that's how we're going to tell them apart. And he just drops in there like that. And it looks like we got our train ready to go almost. Getting this gear in to make sure we got it the right way up, because it's got a little washer that goes in there with it as well. It's going into that spot. Washer to go in with it, and the notorious screw to hold it down. Oh, and we gotta find that one. The next gear going on. That last one was the reverse threaded screw, which this time I remembered to take off correctly when taking off. When I was putting back on, I was wondering why it was clicking there until I realized the reverse threading. So, did not break it this time and shear the head off, which is a bonus. So, we'll get this one put on and we will continue on. You don't need to watch me screw this down. So we'll pause it here. The bridge over the train of wheels is next. We'll get this on here. These two holes line up. That. And then the fun part of getting those points to drop in. That one obviously is going to go into the center wheel. That's going to go over here. Okay, that might be it. We will see. And holding it down, let's see if we've got everything moving here. Looks okay. I think that's it. They're turning. So hopefully they are in their jewels properly. Let's get them tightened down. This bridge was a little tricky to get on there over the train of wheels and the escape wheel, but you can finally see when we turn the, everything is turning freely there. So next is the pallet fork to get in. And this is ever so tiny. I'm going to put this on off camera and then put the bridge over it and then show it hopefully reacting with power in the train of wheels. Alrighty, there we have a problem, Houston. When trying to get this pallet fork back in, I was trying to figure out why it wouldn't sit in the jewel on the bottom pivot. So when I'm taking a closer look here, if you can see that, but the we're going blurry now, but anyways, the bottom pivot is broken on this pallet fork. So the question is, what to do? How to fix this? We have come up with a solution, and it possibly may work. If you remember from my last video, this bulova here, I had inadvertently sheared off one of the screws, trying to take it off, so it's put me on hold. This bulova is roughly from the same time period as the Gruen, so I've taken the pallet fork out of this watch to use as a donor for the Gruen, and let's see if it's going to work. And we have a successful transplant. I've put that pallet fork from the bulova in, put the balance wheel back in, and gave it a little push, and we have a heartbeat. She's alive. We have a runner now. So let's continue putting the rest of the parts back in and see if we can case this. Here is something interesting I wanted to point out. There's a little area here, and this pivot here. So I have a feeling that this arm has broken off, and there should be something connecting to that little pivot there, but I'm not absolutely sure because I can't find any pictures of any previous things on the internet like this one to see if it should be there or not. So the only way to really know if there's a piece broken is to keep going and see if it will work or not without it. But when I took it apart and I looked back in the videos and the photos, there wasn't anything falling out, nor was there anything floating around. So not sure about this one, but we'll continue on and see what's going on here. If you want to leave any comments on what you think there, that would be appreciated. But we'll see if this thing will work with what it has. Again, we did another off-camera adjustment here. What I had issues with was getting the keyless works back together so it will start winding the spring, as well as adjust the time setting gears here. So now we can see that now I've got it all in position where it should be. Is I can adjust the gears, and I can also wind the movement. And as we see, we still got a running watch. So far, so good. So I haven't seen any purpose for this little pivot point right here, or post, whether or not it should have been attached, arm coming there or not. So we're just having to keep going and finish putting this back together, see if everything functions. Let's hold on. All right, and next is this little gear here. Get this back on. And we are going to put this little tiny washer back on it too. Don't want to forget that. If we can ever get it to go on there. It doesn't want to. Things just don't want to go back the way they came on. Sometimes I just have to convince them, right? So once we get that on, now we can place the dial back on and then continue on with the other side. Now we've got the winding works placed in position. And we'll get the screws put in here and it tightened down and tested out. And screw that down. And once it's in place, we'll finish with the last screw, which I won't bore you with. Okay. Now, let's try and get this dial on here. Just line it up. Can line it up. There it is. Okay. And you look for the screw holes and just tighten them up. So. There's one there. I'm not sure if it's going to be in focus or not, but I think you get the idea of what I'm doing. So there's two of them, one on either side. We'll just tighten them up and then move on to the hands. First, we're going to get the hour hand on. And we'll just line it up with next, we'll position and secure the minute hand here. And if you're wondering why I'm not using one of those Bergeron hand pushers, I don't have one yet. So we're going to have to make do with our stone knives and bearskins. And last but not least, the seconds hand. Look at that, ladies and gentlemen. We have a ticker. Okay, let's get the case on this now. Next is going to be the retaining ring. Just get this in here before the movement goes in. This slides in here. Just got to line up the notch with the opening. Make sure that's all seated in there. Looks like it is now. Okay. And now our lovely movement over top. And we'll just get that lined up so you get the winding stem back in. Sorry there, my memory failed me for a second, and now I realize this ring goes in like this. Once the movement's in and the stem is in place, I had to go back again and look at those photos, which is invaluable at times. So now that we get this on, just have to get it lined up with the cutout that's on there. And then once it's lined up, we can get the gasket on there. I got that ring in place. I put the original gasket back on. Put a little bit of silicone grease on top of it. So at least it'll last. That'll be something to replace, obviously, when I get more equipment. So, last but not least is to put the back on. quick little update. What you haven't seen, because it's so small, is this watch was stopping and starting after I got everything together. So one thing I did off camera is the jewel on the underside of the balance there. I took it out, cleaned it, oiled it, and put it back, which was so hard without all the magnification that others have, but I was able to do it, and this watch has been running for 12 hours straight on a wind here and keeping fairly good time. So one thing to do though next is, you can't really see it in this shot on the video, but the seconds hand is curved upward a little bit. So it appears when I've put the case on it, the crystal, it touches the crystal there and stops it. So I'm going to have to take that second hands off and just try and straighten that out there and then get it back inside its case. All right, so this is the next step, and hopefully you'll see it in the case running fine. That last image in the video, it would have been the time grapher that I found an app to place on my cell phone. It's not very fancy, but at least it gave me an idea of how the watch was running for minutes per second, and also for how many times it's beating there. So now that everything seems to be working okay, let's get a band on this watch and finish up this video here. If you've been enjoying it to this point and you're still watching, I'd really appreciate if you like the video and even subscribe if you'd like to see more videos of this nature on this channel. So we're going to wrap up with putting a nice band on this, and then we will finish this up with a view of it, how it looks on the wrist. So I'm not going to bore you with putting this on, and we'll just move on to the wrist shot. But to finalize this, in case you're curious how big this watch is, it's not counting the crown, it's 32 millimeters diameter, and it is from lug to lug 15 millimeters. Okay, so when we come back, we'll be on the wrist. And there we go, the Gruen Precision autowind up and running again. And fits pretty good on the wrist there, not too overpowering like some of the current watches. So I hope you enjoyed this video. As I said before, not a professional, just trying to enjoy the hobby. But if you want to see more like this, you know, please like or subscribe, and hopefully I'll get a few more on here that I have lined up. Thanks again for watching, and enjoy your day. Take care.